Hey guys, it's Clint Paschal, teaching pastor of the Waters Church. Hey, let's talk about motivation. So many things in life boil down to your motivation. What is your motivation? I want to teach y'all about something that Jesus said in Matthew 25, a very popular teaching from Jesus. And he said something that for years I didn't quite get what he was saying. And I want to give you another way to think about something that he said. I think it was incredible, and I think that it helps us as we are asking the question, what is my motivation to do good? Okay, so we're in Matthew 25. This is a specific place where Jesus is talking to people that are declared righteous. And so just go ahead and put yourself in that group. If you are a Christian, you've been saved, your sins have been forgiven, you're not trying to earn your way to heaven, but you, because you know that your goodness is not gonna outweigh your badness and all that cultic stuff that doesn't work, you are saved. Jesus has saved you, your sins are forgiven. Go ahead and declare yourself righteous because you are in Jesus' name. So it is to the righteous that Jesus said something very interesting. We're talking about finding the motivation for doing good. Here's what he said. It says the king, that's Jesus, he says to those righteous people, come, receive your inheritance. For I was hungry, and you gave me something to eat. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you welcomed me in. I needed clothes, and you clothed me. I was sick, you looked after me. I was imprisoned, and you came to visit me. Okay, then the righteous are going, huh? It literally says, the righteous will answer him and say, when did we see you all of those things? When did we see you hungry and thirsty and needing of clothes and sick and a stranger and in prison? When did we see that? Jesus responds in Matthew 25, verse 40 with this. He says, I tell you the truth, whatever you did to the least of these, you did it unto me. Okay, so least of these. This is where we get that teaching. Least of these. This is an interesting phrase because way too many of us will allow our brains to go somewhere that Jesus didn't intend for it to do. When you hear least of these, if you're honest and you read this passage, if you're honest, you quite possibly might think of a guy living under a bridge. You might think of somebody that is just absolutely in the most dire straits ever. And so if we apply least, that phrase least, to that person, then naturally you're going to find yourself to be a little bit better than that least person. But wait a minute. Biblically, we know that God doesn't play favorites. In one of my favorite chapters in the whole Bible, Acts chapter 10, where God is basically welcoming in the Gentiles to his story, Peter says, I've realized now that God does not show favoritism. It's repeated again in Romans chapter 2. God does not show partiality. He is not a respecter of people at different social statuses. So wait a second. Does the least of these apply to a person's social status? Is the least of these applying to an actual value statement of a person? Because if it does, we're messed up a little bit because we start thinking that we're better than a person who's in dire straits. And I'm no better than a person who has no home. That person is a child of God just as much as me. God works just as hard to save that person as he works as hard to save me. So what is this talking about? Well, I think it has everything to do with the list that Jesus just said. There were a few things he mentioned. Hunger, thirst, being a stranger, being naked, needing of clothing, sick, and imprisoned. He said, whatever you did to the least of these. So think about this in a different way for a moment. I want you to think about those things as conditions. Conditions. Being sick is a condition. It's not a value statement on your personhood. Being a stranger, and many of you can relate with what it feels like to be a stranger, that's not a value statement on who you are. That's not a most or a least thing in terms of intrinsic value. That's a condition. Being hungry, being thirsty, being in prison. In my line of work, I will go to prisons and I will visit a prisoner. But as I'm looking at the prisoner across the glass, I'm not better than that person. That person is experiencing a condition. So think of it this way. Jesus said to the righteous, you want a motivation to do good? When you have done the least bit of work to help a person with even the least of these conditions, you did it unto me. Next time you offer somebody in your home a bottle of water, it's a great thing to do, by the way. Somebody comes over, offer them two. If you listen, you'll hear Jesus say from Matthew 25, thanks, I was thirsty. If you take a meal to somebody, if you find out somebody's hurting, and you stoop to help, it is Jesus that looks up to you and says, thanks, I needed that. What is your motivation to do good? Jesus takes our conditions, even the least of them, so personally that when we reach out to help a person, it's like we're doing it to Jesus himself. Least of these is not a value statement upon people. It's just a simple way of Jesus saying the least amount of effort matters. So find your motivation in doing good because Jesus takes it personally. And this statement, don't forget this. Every little thing you do for a person matters. It all matters. If all you have is a quarter to give, give the quarter. It matters. And all of heaven is inspired and entertained and moved by what we do. It's a pretty good motivation to do good. I hope that helps you as you read Matthew 25 in terms of the least of these teaching. Remember that Psalm chapter 5 says that God's favor is over you like a shield, so go and live in God's favor.